In this video, we're going to be using this same scene from Factory I.O. that sorts boxes based on height. The difference between this assignment and the previous assignment is that you will be using function block diagrams to program this system instead of ladder diagrams. If you'll recall, this system sorts boxes by height, where short boxes go down this ramp and the tall boxes go down this ramp. Here's what the short boxes look like, and here's what the tall boxes look like. This light curtain contains two sensors, one that is set lower and one that is set higher. And based on what those sensors see, we will activate this pneumatic pusher. Not only does the pneumatic pusher extend and retract, but it has a sensor that can detect when it is fully extended or fully retracted. Here's the control panel, and you'll notice that it has a start button. And as always, we want the green light to turn on when we're in run mode. It also has a stop button, and we want the red light to turn on when we're in off mode. The control panel also includes this display, which shows the count of tall boxes that have been sorted, as well as the count of short boxes that have been sorted. And it also has this reset button that will reset the counts to zero. Let's go ahead and start the simulation. If I push the start button, you'll notice that the green light turns on, indicating we're in run mode, and the conveyor will pause and push off the tall boxes, but continue running when it sees a short box. Now we're using a timer to indicate when the conveyor will stop, and I found about 0.85 seconds after the tall box is detected to when we stop the conveyor and push the box off. You'll notice that the counters are keeping track of how many boxes they've seen, and that this button right here will reset the counters to zero. Now, because this is the first program you'll be creating using function block diagrams, let me talk you through this a little bit. You'll notice that we are able to put these green boxes, which are comments, where I can keep track of what each section of the program is doing. This first section is simply initiating the start and stop logic. You haven't seen this function yet in your ladder programming. We call this a flip-flop. This particular one is a reset dominant. When it receives a Boolean true, it will set the output to true and keep it true until the reset receives a Boolean true, at which point it will reset the output back to zero. Now you'll notice that I have this not here. The not reverses the Boolean that's coming into it. For instance, if a true was coming into this, a false would come out. Now the reason I'm using a not with the stop button is because the stop button in the physical world is a normally closed contact. So it's always sending a 1, which I should reverse to a false, until this gets pushed, at which point it breaks the power connection and sends a 0, which I should then reverse to a 1 to reset this. And you'll see I'm using another knot over here. The stop button light will always just be the opposite of the start button light. Now let's move down to this conveyor on-off logic section of my program. You can see that I'm going to be turning the conveyor on based on some logic here, and I'm using these AND functions. There are three conditions that will allow the conveyor to turn on. First, the start button light has to be on, indicating I'm in run mode. I also want to make sure that the pusher has been retracted. I don't want to run the conveyor and potentially run a box into the pusher if it's not retracted. And then you'll also notice that I have this knot that's tied back into this timer. So when the tall box sensor senses a tall box, it sets this RS function so that this is true, starts this timer. And when this timer hits this preset of 850 milliseconds, it will turn this to true. So what we're saying here is when this timer is not done timing, go ahead and keep the conveyor running. But as soon as the timer is done timing, and we're going to be pushing a box off, then we will negate that, and so that the conveyor will not run anymore. And then this section of the program down here is where I'm doing the timing, like we've already discussed, but it's also where I'm counting the tall and short boxes. Now you'll notice with this up counter, it counts up every time the tall box sensor gets tripped. I'm keeping track of the short boxes with this up down counter. Every time the short box sensor gets tripped, I will count up, but the short box sensor gets tripped for short boxes and tall boxes. So if I count up for every time the short box sensor gets tripped, I better count down if it happens to be a tall box. So this counter will only increment up by 1 when it really is a short box.